to the plate and leading us through this past year as our president. You've done an outstanding job, Tom, helping us deal with tax status issues, which in the end turned out to be much simpler than we initially thought. And you brought great speakers to our meetings and great entertainment. And of course, I know Nancy was right there helping you just a little bit. I also want to thank our immediate past president, Rhonda Rhodes, for all the help and camaraderie she has provided to me this year. She's been a great mentor and an outstanding friend to me, and I look forward to spending time with her in the near future. I also would be remiss in not mentioning Nancy and Dawn Swigert, who were most instrumental in convincing me to take on this job. I couldn't turn you down. You just sold me on the job. And you also promised, you gave me the courage to say yes, but you also promised to be part of my team. I want to also thank my Lexington Medical Society Alliance friends, if you want to stand, ladies, at our table. They were the ones who welcomed me with open arms when we moved back to Lexington in 2006. And last, but certainly not least, I would like to recognize my husband, Dr. Rick Pelligrini, for his undying support of me always, but especially now in this endeavor as KMAA president. And I want to thank my daughter, Tricia Shackelford, my granddaughter, Brennan Shackelford, and my grandson, Bo Shackelford, and our dear friends of many years, Kathy and Roy Paul. It takes a village to help a woman rise to the occasion of being president of a very prestigious medical society alliance, and all of these people have helped me to achieve this honor. I would not be here without all of their support. Many of you who have come to know me have learned that I love bumblebees. And this all started when Rick and I moved to North Carolina upon completing his radiology residency and going into private practice. We purchased our dream home there. And since we really had very minimal, decent furniture, we engaged the services of the local interior designer who became a very dear friend. But the bee thing started when she brought fabric to cover our dining room chairs, and that was patterned with bumblebees. I just liked the fabric because it went with an oriental rug we had just purchased. But very soon, friends began giving me gifts of bumblebees. Crazy ones, silly ones, formal ones, you name it, I got it. And it became a theme. And suddenly, I realized I was the bee queen. So as I began to formulate ideas for writing this speech, I started thinking about bees and how they work and realized there's the queen bee and many, many worker bees. Well, that's how the KMA Alliance works. There's the queen bee, that's me now, and many, many worker bees, and trying to produce the honey that everyone will love and want. Well, herein lies the challenge. How do we keep producing the honey that everyone wants? And how do we adapt to the changes in our society and this social media world? In June, I attended the AMA Alliance annual meeting in Chicago. I was very impressed with the speakers, but especially with one person who talked about different generations and how they're adapting to the digital world we find ourselves living in. She said that baby boomers like me are reluctantly being dragged into the digital age of social media. I heard about Google Hangouts for the first time as a way of conducting meetings remotely, but still face-to-face. And we also had a speaker at our Alliance meeting today that gave us even more detail about how to do this. And I hope that I will be able to learn how to do this. We know that the younger generations are much more savvy with these new technologies, and I feel we must continue to adapt to these new ways of communicating. As you know, obtaining any advanced degree, and especially a medical degree, is an arduous and time-consuming commitment. Everyone in the family is impacted, and success is a group effort. I just know that we, the KMA Alliance, have to continue to try to figure out how to appeal to the younger generation of physicians and let them and their families know that we are here to be their support system as they are going through medical school, residency, starting in practice, raising children, and then retiring from practice, as my husband has recently done. And we need to support legislation that won't diminish the doctor-patient relationship any further, but instead is friendly to patients and physicians and results in a stronger doctor-patient bond. And that's where we should focus our goals. We must support spouses, we must advocate for patients and physicians. There are so very many things to do, but we are the family of medicine. We've made many inroads in these goals, but we must continue to do more. So my tagline for this year is, be innovative, BEE, be committed, and be involved. Thank you all for giving me this most prestigious honor of being the 92nd president of the Kentucky Medical Association Alliance. I will do my best to make you proud that you did. Thank you.